Troubling new questions this afternoon in the wake of yesterday's alligator attack on a researcher near Silver Spring State Park in Marion County.
Investigators want to know why the 525-pound, 11-foot alligator showed no fear of humans. West 2's Bob Keeling joins us live outside Silver Springs with the latest on this investigation. And how's the victim today, Bob?
Well, we can tell you that he is much better than yesterday. Meanwhile, in terms of the investigation, state wildlife officers wonder why this large, robust alligator apparently had no fear of humans. They tell us that some of the employees of the park even had a nickname for the animal.
Oh, he's a big-ass alligator. He's hanging right around where it happened.
A co-worker talks to 911 operators just minutes after this 525-pound alligator attacked research diver Peter Butt, who's shown here on a recent dive.
Yeah, he was out looking at a little spring, and this gator came and attacked him.
Okay.
He's got some slashes and cuts.
The attack happened at around 5 o'clock yesterday afternoon under a boathouse just off Silver Springs property. State wildlife officers question why this alligator showed no fear of humans.
It exhibited characteristics that normally you wouldn't find on a wild, lean and mean alligator, meaning that it didn't appear that it had to work too hard for its meals.
Is there a concern that somebody had been feeding it?
I would say that's a fair assumption. And
friends of the victim say Butt was working in a small canal near the Silver Springs, testing the health of the aquifer. He apparently didn't see the large animal. But this gator apparently is known to employees of the park.
When I spoke to some of the staff at Silver Springs, they actually had a name for it. They named it, said it was named Floyd, and that they estimated it had been at the attraction for about 20 years. Now,
a Silver Springs spokesman declined to appear on camera, but told us it's against park policy to feed the alligators, and quote, everyone knows that.
And it is a crime to feed wild alligators in the state of Florida. Meanwhile, just within the last 30 minutes, we did get a new statement from Shands Hospital where they say the victim, Peter Butt, is in good condition. He's in good spirits, and he wants to thank everyone for their concern and well wishes.